Welcome to The Art of Living Big. I'm your host, Betsy Pake, and this podcast is designed to share interviews and new ideas to help you redefine what could be possible for your life. Now, let's go live big. Today's podcast is brought to you by Audible. Get a free audiobook download and a 30-day free trial at audibletrial.com/livebig. There's over 180,000 different titles to choose from, and you can listen on your iPhone, your Android, your Kindle, or your MP3 player. Now, here's the show. Hey, everybody. Welcome to the show. All right, today I'm going to take you in my bag, and we're going to go and get foot zoned. Have you ever heard of this before? So a couple months ago, one of my girlfriends, I was talking to her, and I don't even remember how it came up. Honestly, I don't even know like what I said that triggered it, but she said, oh, you should go see my friend Kate. She's a foot zoner. And so at the time, like literally, I didn't even know what it was then, but she said that. And like a few hours later, I was in this woman's living room getting foot zoned. So what I will tell you is that today I'm going to a totally different woman, and I'm still not super clear on what foot zoning is. I know what I experienced, which was sort of like, it felt like maybe what reflexology is. So, I sat on the couch and the woman, Kate, sat on like a little bench and she did some, like it was almost like a foot massage for like 45 minutes. But really what it did was it made me feel very aligned and really intuitive to what is happening around me. Like almost like when my family came in, I knew what they were experiencing or thinking about, and it was really kind of a cool experience. Anyway, I don't know what today will be like, but I'm gonna take you in my bag and we're gonna go figure it out. All right, here we go. All right, I am here at my appointment for my foot zoning. I'm with Alicia Marker. Hey, Alicia.
Hi, how are you?
I'm really impressed with myself for getting your name right. I don't know why that's so hard for me. We all have our struggles.
Yes.
Okay, so I did like a little pre-thing so people kind of knew that I'd had this done before.
Yes.
But even when I had it done before, I didn't really know what I was doing or what the purpose was for it and like why it was all going down. So can you tell me a little bit about what foot zoning really is?
Yes. So foot zoning looks at the body as like a holistic instrument. And so all of the systems of the body were designed to work together. And when one of those is out of balance, your body doesn't perform as well as it should. And so if you're sick or have a headache, your body doesn't perform as well. So foot zoning actually works off of the map of your body that is on your foot, and it touches different signals in your body on your feet, and it brings those in alignment.
So like when I'm thinking of a foot, so the image I have in my head is of a palm reader. You know how like different areas of your palm, there's like a map, like if you Googled that, right?
Yes.
And is that the same with your feet? Like your feet, is it what massage therapists use also, or is this different?
It's very similar to massage and reflexology, but it takes it just a little bit beyond that, because it works on the body as a whole. Like I wouldn't just focus on your sinuses. I would work every single system in your body and every signal on your foot. And so just like you have the map of the body on your foot, you also have it on your hands. So it is very similar to that.
Okay.
But when you do a zone, you start on the right foot and you end on the left foot, and you do a whole zone every single time. You don't just work on one single part.
So I don't come to you and just say, my shoulder hurts, can you help me?
Right, because I don't know what it is that is causing your shoulder pain. So it might be something actually that happened, that you're storing things in your body from your past. And it might be something that you're storing in your body generations past. And so I don't know what it is that we're going to be working on when I work on your shoulder, but it might be something that you might not think of.
So that's fascinating. So I did a podcast. I actually recorded it this morning.
Oh, okay.
And it's on the movie Emotion, have you seen this?
I have not seen it, but it's on my list of things to want to watch.
Yes. So it's really good, but it's that same exact concept, which I completely believe that we hold stuff in our bodies, and there have been studies, and the one that I cited this morning when I was talking was from the University of Utah, where they did an epigenetic study on mice and made them fearful of cherry blossoms. And so they would shock them.
Yes.
Then they would have babies, and those babies would have babies, and those babies' babies were scared of cherry blossoms,
yes.
Which makes sense from a survival point of view that we would harbor that stuff. So I'm mesmerized by this because I feel like I went through such a traumatic experience when I was younger. My mom died, and I talk about that in that emotion episode that I did. But that was so traumatic that – and a lot of stress changes your DNA, right? So – I was holding the eggs for my daughter.
Yes.
Right? And she now has crazy anxiety. And I go back to that and I wonder, is some of that stuff that she's bringing up that is like really ancient, it's really from me. And not that I'm ancient. I'm young and hip. But
you're totally young and hip. I love it.
But is that something that happens, right? That happens to people.
Yes, it totally is. And I actually read something just yesterday that when we are in our mother's wombs, we form the eggs in our bodies at, I think, 4 months.
And oh, right. So I have stuff in me that was my grandmother's.
Yes. Yes. So you actually were in your grandmother's womb when your mother was in your grandmother's
womb. I mean, I am like, aha. Like, mind blown. Like, if we were on Facebook, I'd put a GIF of like a like, whoa.
Yeah.
So, okay.
It's
so
like we have the generations past. So when people say, you know, can we be affected generationally? Absolutely we can. Yeah. And when you think about that kind of a concept.
So not that I want to start talking about past lives, but that does make you go, you're affected by past lives, just not your own.
Right. Absolutely. Yes. And so that's one of the things that the foot zone actually works on energy as well. And so it's not just the signals on your body. I actually do energy work with you at the same time.
Like the Reiki was, yes, energy work.
Absolutely. And so, there are, depending on what it is that you're carrying, and it's kind of like foot zoning is kind of like peeling the layers of an onion. Mm-hmm. And so we work, you know, on the outer layers first. And when you first start coming to a foot zoner, you might need to see a foot zoner, you know, pretty regularly every week or 2 weeks for the first few months while you're working, because you might be peeling those onion layers and you're getting deeper, deeper, deeper to get that body into balance. And so you might be removing hooks and energy from, like I said, past generations that you don't even know that you're carrying, that something happened, you know, to your grandmother or to her grandmother that has been carried down through the DNA.
That's fascinating. Okay, so how did you get into all this? Because when I first, I mean, literally someone told me about foot zoning and like 3 hours later, I was like at the lady's house. And so I don't even know how I found it. So how did you find it? Like, what happened?
So a few years ago, because of the oils that I work with, a woman brought Kate, who was my instructor, my guru.
And my foot zoner.
Zoner. to give a demonstration. And I was in this room and I was waiting for her to come in, and she walked in the door and I heard audibly in my ear, you were going to take a class from her. Mm. And there was nobody sitting by me. I was all by myself in this room. And so it was very odd that it came so clearly. But so I just kind of held that and watched her give the demonstration, and I was fascinated, and it was beautiful, and the person that she demonstrated on was very open and shared, you know, a lot with us that night. And so at the end of the class, somebody stood up and said, this is all really fascinating, and I think there's a lot of us here that would love to learn from you. Mm-hmm. When are you going to teach a class on this? And she said, I have no intention on teaching a class ever.
And you were like, oh, yes, you do.
I thought to myself, oh, you will be teaching a class. Yeah. That's what you think. So about 18 months ago, my son and I were involved in a very serious car accident. And it was something that I feel like I was saved from. And there was definitely, you know, a presence in my car that kept us protected. Yeah. And from that point on, I kind of had a shift in my thinking, because I really felt like I had been saying no to a lot of the things with my energy work that I was interested in, mm-hmm. because I felt like it was something I wanted and not something that, you know, God or the universe wanted for me. Mm-hmm. And so I really...
Isn't it funny how we do that? Like, if we want something, right. if it's coming to us, it's right. because that's the path, right?
Right, right. But in my recent studies over the past few months now, mm-hmm. I have a better understanding of... you know, why things were continuing to be put into my path. And I kept saying no. And so I think that when we had the accident, I really had a shift in what I was thinking and what I was being drawn to. And so I really wanted to focus more on, you know, honoring that path and the truth and, you know, seeking things out for discovering.
Yeah.
You know.
So then, and then did it just happen that Kate was running a class and...
That's exactly
just right when you needed it, right?
Yeah, when the student is ready, the teacher will appear.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was. And so she had posted that she was going to be teaching a class, mm-hmm. and I ran downstairs to my husband and I said, I want to take this class. I have no idea how we're going to do it, but I feel like this is what I need to do.
Yeah.
And he said, we'll figure out a way to make it work then.
So you've been doing this now, you finished your certification, what, like maybe 4 or 5 months ago?
No, actually it's just been within the past 2 months.
Oh, okay. So pretty recent.
Yes.
Cool.
Very new.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. So tell me what to expect. Like, how do we do this? So you have like this little stool, which, okay, so now let me just lay out kind of where we are, what's happening. I'm at your house. I came to your house to do it, which you also just like, when I had my Reiki done, mm-hmm. you have these salt lamps, which makes me go like, I need to get a salt lamp. Mm-hmm. So, and it smells good in here. I'm guessing it's like the aromatherapy stuff.
It's actually, I Palo Santo'd the space. So I cleared out all of the other energies that were here before.
What's Palo Santo?
Palo Santo is a holy wood, like frankincense or myrrh.
Mm.
And so it, when you burn it, it's kind of like saging. And so you...
Okay, so I've just saged the very first time. So tell me what that is, because now I feel like, what is that? Palo Santo? So do you buy like Palo Santo?
Yeah, they're sticks. Yep. I'll show you them later.
Okay, yeah.
But they're sticks of wood and...
And you burn it like incense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you...
Because it smells really good.
Yeah, I love it. And so when we moved in here, I used that around the house and I, you know, feathered and so it got into all the corners.
Yeah.
But it's important when you clear a space, you actually have to open a window or a door so that the energy
goes out. Like, that's like when I sage.
Yes.
Like, I got to have a door or a window open.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it can... leave the space. So
okay, cool. So okay, so it smells really good. You got like some good music going, and we've got sort of the salt lamp, like ambiance of it all. So I like it.
Yeah.
Okay, so it feels cozy. Okay,
awesome.
All right. So we're gonna get started.
Great.
All right. Okay, so this is a little different than Reiki because I can talk and record because I'm sitting on the couch and she's got my foot up on her lap and she's put... Now, you picked oils for me specifically, right?
Yeah. Yes, I did. I picked certain oils for you based on what your energy told me you needed today.
And the thing I thought was cool, y'all, is that she picked them based on muscle testing. And do you remember if you listened to the emotion... podcast that we did, we talked about muscle testing. So she did it based on that. And I saw you were sort of leaning forward or leaning back, right?
Yeah.
So she was doing the one that I was talking about how I did. So she picked out like 4 different oils, I think, for me. And now she's just like pressing on parts of my foot. And I've apologized for my lack of pedicure, but it doesn't seem to bother her. So I'm just going to let her do her thing and I'll be back. All right, so we're like sort of getting to the end here, and Alicia's been, you know, doing whatever she does here with the zoning, pushing on stuff and massaging stuff, and she just asked me, if you've listened to the Emotion podcast that I did, and I recorded it this morning, okay, so it's fresh on my mind, but I want you to go ahead and ask me the question you just asked me again.
Have your bowel movements been?
And so when she asked me that, I was like, why? T- tell me why. Can you tell me why, or you just can tell something, or what?
I feel like there's a block in there.
Yeah.
And it didn't want me to, because part of what I do is, you know, moving things around in your body and moving things out of your body, yep. Both physically and emotionally. Yep. And there's something on your emotional side that's blocking in your colon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the colon, y'all, if you haven't listened to that episode. So let me tell you, since you haven't listened to the episode, because it has not actually aired yet when we're recording this, but when I did the emotion code, I found that there was a lot of grief, abandonment, and sadness in my colon.
Yes.
And so I have been doing the emotion code process, and the first day was like, oh, there was a lot of activity. And I didn't realize until I did that, and I don't know why this didn't occur to me before, but so when I did the emotion code and I came up with colon, I was like, that is so strange because I don't have an issue with my colon. And as soon as I said that, I thought, I have gone to the hospital like probably 4 times in the last 10 years because I'm holding so much in my colon, I get spasms and I have to go to the hospital. Like, and it hasn't happened like in 4 years probably. So I really didn't remember, which is weird that I didn't remember. But then to have that, and then to have you say that's where the blockage is too, is just very interesting. So
that's wild.
Yeah. This energy stuff, there's something to it.
It's kind of crazy.
So tell me, and that's funny. Also, one word I'm trying to change, because as I've been going through and having all these experiences, I use the word weird a lot, which actually, if you look up the definition of weird, is supernatural.
Oh, yeah.
So weird actually fits.
Yes.
But weird has this connotation that's bad, or I'll say crazy. And so I'm trying to change that.
Oh, yeah.
And so that instead I say, like, that's really beautiful.
It is. Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
I love that so much more.
Yeah.
Yes.
Right? So it's really beautiful that you were able to sense that in my energy.
Thank you. I'm totally going to borrow that.
Take that. Take that. Everybody can take that. Tell me, can you talk while you do this?
Sure.
So tell me what else. And my friend Joy and I both want you to just tell me about how good my energy is.
Your energy is amazing. I love it. And I had fun playing in your crown chakra.
Yeah. So you've been going through, and we found a couple other things, right? You were asking about some stuff in my shoulder.
Oh, yeah. So what came up for me there was, you know, having to deal with your mom. And so a lot of times the emotion part of the shoulder is carrying the weight of the world, you know, on our shoulders.
And the interesting thing that I thought is, are you done? Okay. But you're going to just hold my feet.
Yeah.
The interesting thing I thought was I've had shoulder surgery. And so I realize that what I'm about to say may sound a little far-fetched, and I'm almost thinking through it as I'm saying it out loud. But when you were sensing the emotion in my shoulder, it was more like the weight of the world on my shoulders, and it was associated with my mom. And so I wonder if that's why that's what broke down on my body, right? Like
That totally makes sense, because when we carry emotion and we have breakdowns in our body, and when we have dis-ease in our body, it creates disease in our body. And so when we feel those emotions and we feel negative and emotions, depression, sadness, things that have happened to us in our past, and again, things that we didn't even know that we're carrying with us through our DNA and our genetics. You know, when we have those in our body does break down, and we can get back to that homeostasis and that balance in our body by changing the energy, you know, bringing in new energy, good energy, and taking out the bad energy. And so it absolutely makes sense that, you know, your shoulder needed the surgery because that's what you've been carrying all these years.
It's heavy. That's been very heavy. So the other interesting thing I found is you were kind of like in my foot, in the middle of my foot, and we were talking about food. How did that come up? You were asking about my thyroid.
Yeah, your thyroid was very angry.
Yes. And so I was just saying that I have really tried to switch a little bit so that I, like the last 4 days, much more ketogenic in terms of what the food is I'm eating. I'm really trying to cut out a lot of processed stuff. But the interesting thing is I asked you, I said, I've been really thinking about going vegetarian.
And it was really funny because then my body reacted in a very positive way. And the muscle testing that you talked about doing earlier, my sway happened when you said that. So I know you were kidding, but my reaction to that was, yes, that's totally what you should do.
Yeah, so I got confirmation. And you know what's really interesting is last year I did 3 episodes on vegetarianism. So I had a vegan on, a vegetarian, and like a raw food, like a juice guy. And I brought them on the show because I was in meditation and I heard my body say, we really want more vegetables. And so it's interesting because now as I have moved towards more ketogenic, although I'm cutting out processed foods and I'm eating more like salads and stuff like that, I'm also eating a lot more animal products. And so that really has given me food for thought, so to speak, because I'm going like, well, okay, maybe I just need to reevaluate. And before every meal, muscle test and just really see, like, use my intuition to determine what it is my body really wants.
Yeah, absolutely. That's really a great way to look at it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This was so fun.
I'm so glad that we did this.
Yeah, thank you for all of the foot fun.
Oh, you're welcome. You are so welcome. It's been amazing.
All right.
And really beautiful.
It's been really beautiful. So I hope everybody enjoyed jumping in my bag while I got foot zoned today. It was definitely an experience. I feel really good. Like I said, just still super relaxed. I feel like I got some good information and confirmation, and hopefully just kind of helped that energy shift a little bit that I've been working so hard at making a transformation in. Now, if you live near me and you'd like to go see Alicia, then just reach out to me and let me know, and I'll make sure to connect you. So thanks so much for listening to another episode of The Art of Living Big. Thanks for spending some time with me today. Remember, you can find me inside my Facebook group at sslbcommunity.com. That stands for Start Small, Live Big Community.com. And as always, here's a little message from my husband.
Woo! That's it!